This is AREX MTX training ammo. If you're not familiar, this is a special kind of ammunition made specifically for training purposes. It's designed to work in real firearms with certain modifications, so you're unable to fire live rounds. The projectiles are plastic cups that contain paint and are relatively light, so the velocity and energy is low enough that you can shoot other people.
You think this is gonna hurt?
Of course, only with proper safety equipment. So essentially, MTX training ammo is just the more expensive version of paintball or airsoft. But it has one big advantage. Because it works in your real gun, you can use your own setup, which brings a lot of value, for example, for special forces or other professionals that see value in highly realistic training. Besides full force-on-force training, training ammo also gives you an option to do team drills, CQB, room clearing, and similar in a safe manner, shooting at targets at point-blank range. For this kind of drills, the minimal safety equipment are ballistic glasses that will help in a case of accidental friendly fire or ricochets.
Present! Guys, it's clear. Let's go.
But the best part, of course, is force-on-force training. This means that you set up a certain scenario where you shoot each other. In this case, we had Luca playing a barricaded suspect without ballistic protection, armed with a rifle and a handgun. On the other side, we have a four-man team armed with rifles and handguns with additional protection of ballistic vests and a ballistic shield. Essentially, our job was to find and eliminate the target. First, we had to approach the building. Immediately, we came in contact from the left side. We returned fire and used a smoke grenade to cover that flank. Once at the building, we left one guy to cover the rear, and the rest of us started to advance to the next corner. Now, we knew that there was only one enemy, and that these rooms were not connected to the others, but it just felt wrong to just pass them. So we did a quick search, cleared the rooms, and advanced to the corner. So by now, you can probably already see the difference of this non-scripted force-on-force exercise and what we showed first in the video, that was more of a scenario-based room clearing against a cardboard target. In this situation, we are going against an opponent that is determined, highly skilled, and has the terrain in his advantage. Honestly, nobody wants to get hit by the MTX ammo because it hurts like a motherfucker. Initial idea was to do room clearing drills, but the bad guy had different plans and set up an ambush. Second guy in the stack was hit two times, once in his abdominal area, and one of the bullets was stopped with his front plate armor. It's interesting to note here how just a shot of adrenaline and the communication completely fell apart. People were not sure where to go and what to do. I received a couple of hits in my right arm near the elbow area, so I decided to just apply the tourniquet and still be in the game, by using my left hand.
Ah, hit!
Once the suspect was down, I tended to our injured teammate, and Luca and Nate moved forward to do the checkup. A moment of distraction, and we got another casualty. This was a super fun exercise that left us with many lessons to learn.
So I was hit 2 times in the elbow. My right hand is off. He was hit
inside here
from the side, like this. So he would be in critical condition probably. And one was saved by the vest.
After a quick reset, we are back in game. This one starts faster, with a suspect engaging us from the front, and we quickly realize the advantage of the ballistic shield and fire superiority. We felt confident enough to take a wider angle and push the suspect. The luck was on our side because the suspect experienced 2 malfunctions with his main rifle. This was not the fault of the training ammunition, but actually a mistake from the operator. Luca is not super familiar with the SCAR rifle, and in a heat of battle, he transitioned to his left shoulder to shoot around the corner. Now, as you can see here, with his right hand, he interacted with the charging handle of the SCAR rifle, which reciprocates with every shot. If you block the charging handle, it will not cycle the next round. Since it functions completely the same as a real rifle would, this shows the added value of this training exercise, because the same malfunction would not happen with an airsoft rifle, for example. We decided to just continue from the point where we stopped. Here's an interesting situation where we didn't realize that Luca was looking at us from the other side of the building through the windows, but again, the ballistic shield showed its value. Now in this situation, I realize that we are bunched up and nobody is covering our rear. If the suspect flanks us, comes around the corner and just peeks, he has a clear shot on all of us. We are in an open area. We correct our mistake just in time. It was interesting to hear Luca's feedback. When he picked the corner, he was staring at a shield and multiple guns aiming at him. He felt like he was not able to hit us or hurt us. Ballistic shield is definitely not a solution for every problem, but it gives you a very good tactical and psychological advantage. We also tried team deathmatch with 2 versus 3 people without the use of the ballistic shield. The goal here is just to shoot at each other.
Bennett!
And of course, the day wouldn't be complete without some old-fashioned quick draw.
Hey, what are you doing? What are you doing, guys? Hey guys, what are you doing?
Nothing. We're just walking around. And I was black.
What's the matter?